All right, welcome back to Yahoo Finance's special presentation of the future of retail. I'm Brian Sozzi, still stationed in very cold New York City, seeing it get a little dark out here. The temperatures are dropping. You hear that cement truck moving, lots of tourists coming back here into the city. The crowds have been very strong, a lot different holiday shopping season this year compared to last year. But let's say in all things holiday shopping and bring in BDO's national practice leader, Natalie Cutler. Good to see you.
Good to see you, Brian. Thanks for having us.
Of course. So what's your outlook for the holiday season?
So I think to make a big story easy, simple, is this holiday season, we're expecting to see fewer markdowns. Mm-hmm. Fewer markdowns in the store than we have seen in quite some time. As you know, most consumers are looking for that hot ticket item on Black Friday, on Cyber Monday, and I think we're going to see fewer of those, primarily driven by the supply chain issues that we're seeing for the last 6 to 9 months.
How intense is the inflation in retail right now?
So inflation is definitely playing a role in pricing. I think that consumers are starting to get anxious about it. We did see an increase in October sales of 1.7%. But again, I think some of that was driven by inflation. Consumers are not necessarily buying more items. They are paying more for those items. I think one thing really important to remember is that the consumer's wallet is not infinite. The consumer has a fixed budget. They're going to spend what they're going to spend. Some may spend over, and they'll see that in their bills in January, but that's a whole other story.
I'm sure they will. Well, some of these retail executives I've talked to think we all have infinite wallets, so I can assure you that. Are you surprised how consumers have overcome inflation? We've seen a lot of retailers, they reported earnings. Sales are pretty good. Stocks, not so much, but still, consumers have come out here and shopped.
I think it's the excitement of coming back into the store, coming back into some level of normalcy that we haven't seen in quite some time. We'll probably see that continuing into November and then in December. I do believe that once those bills come in January and February.
Those are the worst.
Exactly. And that's, I think that's what's going to happen in Q1. We'll definitely see a slowdown in purchasing in Q1. However, that's going to be a double down for the retailers, because all of the goods that are on the water right now, they're going to be coming in January, February, March. And those could be older goods that will need to be marked down. So retailers are going to be having a double whammy. One is you're going to have a smaller wallet because all those credit card bills are coming in. And two, they're going to need to get rid of and liquidate that inventory.
I've been hearing that too. Like the first part of next year could be interesting for retail. It sounds like it could be a sea of markdowns in retail.
I do believe there's going to be a significant amount of markdowns, because think about it, you're receiving goods that have been underwater potentially mm-hmm. for quite some time. So you may be getting sweaters in March. You may be getting outdated technology in March, and that's going to require markdowns.
When do you see the supply chain bottlenecks getting better?
I don't see that happening at least for some time. I think that this will continue at least into the back-to-school season of 2022 and potentially into the holiday season. You know, my advice to retailers is plan wisely, plan early, and plan ahead so you know what you'll be doing come November of 2022.
You know, if we zoom out, what is the state of retail post-pandemic? And we're still in the pandemic in many respects, of course, but I mean, I look around the city here, there are so many stores still closed. It's kind of jarring. Right across the street was a JCPenney. That's no longer there anymore. I mean, what's the state of retail?
You know, I think COVID has really turned retail in a different direction. It's definitely gone more to a digital way. Brick and mortar is going to be alive forever. You know, many years ago, or for the past several years, everyone has been saying, brick and mortar is going to die, brick and mortar is going to die. Brick and mortar is not going anywhere. It's going to morph. And brick and mortar is going to partner with e-commerce. So whether that's through a very strong omni-channel concept, whether that's utilizing BOPIS, e-commerce and
it's buy online, pick up in store.
Correct. Sorry, buy online, pick up in store.
No, it's cold out here. I know, we get used to all this retail stuff. I understand. Do you still see retailers opening up stores post-pandemic?
Definitely. We're seeing a lot of retailers opening up stores, those that have a good, strong strategy, digital strategy, a strategy related to how to employ their employees properly and retain those employees. How to build strong brand loyalty is critical today. You know, the worst thing that could happen to a retailer is if you buy something online or it has availability online, but you go to the store and it's not there. That is the most frustrating experience for a consumer and will certainly hurt the brand loyalty to the retailer.
Before I let you go, you mentioned labor. And I know the supply chain bottlenecks, those will eventually end, but is labor one of the biggest problems in retail after the pandemic? We've seen a lot of retailers raise wages to $15 an hour, but they still can't get the workers they need.
It's definitely going to be a significant issue going forward. I think in retail as well as in other different industries, the key is to understand and to offer what the young generation is looking for, whether that's giving them a special technology to work with, whether it's bonuses, whether it's wages. That's going to be the most critical aspect, is understanding how to bring those employees in.
Before I let you go, any big holiday plans for you? It's good to be out, right?
It is awesome to be out, and I will be out this holiday weekend. I hope everybody's out there shopping, so shop big and early.
Shop big. All right, well, thank you so much. Natalie Cutler of BDO, good to see you. Thanks for braving the frigid cold for us. We appreciate it. We'll talk to you soon.
Great. Thank you so much, Brian.